हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू योर फिजिक्स क्लास. दिस इज योर फिजिक्स टीचर. होप यू ऑल आर गुड. इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर 5 हीट. नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर 6 साउंड. व्हाट इज साउंड? साउंड इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ एनर्जी विच प्रोड्यूसेस सेंसेशन ऑफ हियरिंग इन अवर ईयर्स. द इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ साउंड इज दैट इट हेल्प्स अस टू कम्युनिकेट विद ईच अदर. So sound is the only way of communication among animals, while it is the primary way of communication among human beings. As we know, different types of objects can produce different sounds. In the everyday life, we hear different types of sounds. So the sounds produced can be produced by the living as well as the non-living things. For example, barking of a dog, speech in public places, beats of a drum. These includes the sounds produced by the living things as well as the non-living things, and these can be easily heard and can be recognized. But there are certain types of sounds like whispering. Whispering means the low sounds having the small amplitude, and the fluttering leaves, that means when leaves moves here and there. So these types of sounds will have low volume music which require a peaceful environment to recognize. So this is about sound, that sound helps us to talk with each other and it is very important for the communication. Now we will see that how sound is produced. So sound is produced when the particles present in an object vibrates. As we know, objects can have particles in between them, and when the objects are given some energy to vibrate, so that then the sound will be produced by the particles present in the objects, by the vibrating particles present in that object. So sound, we can say that it is produced by vibrating objects. For example, when we touch our throat with the help of our fingers while talking, then we will be able to feel the vibration. So in this way, sound is produced. Now, if we talk about the sources of sound, then we can say that human beings or the living beings are the sources of sound, and there are some musical instruments and other instruments which can produce the sound. But mainly or primarily, the sound is produced by the living beings like the humans. Now we will see that how we can produce sound and how we can hear that sound. So here I will explain the sources, the source of sound that is present in our body. So in our throat we have a structure which is called a voice box or larynx, that is present in the neck region, that helps us to produce sound when we talk. The larynx contains two membranous tissues which are called vocal cords. Vocal cords are the membranous tissues. What is the meaning of membranous? A membrane means a thin layer. Like when we peel off onion, then a white layer is over there. So that white layer can be termed as a membrane. Similarly, a thin layer of the tissues is known as the vocal cords, that is present in the throat, which is having a narrow slit. Narrow slit means it is an opening or a narrow cut in between the vocal cords, which is done to allow the passage of air, which is made for the passage of air. So the vocal cords are held together by the muscles that control the vibrations of the cords. While talking or making a sound, air enters through the windpipe, and this air causes the vocal cords to vibrate. The vibration of the vocal cords then produces the sound. So vibration, we all know that this is the to and fro motion of the objects. Just is tarah se aage piche objects move karte hain like this, then that is known as to and fro motion, that is known as vibration. So the vibration of the vocal cords produces sound. As I have already told that if we touch our throat while talking, then we can feel the vibration of the vocal cords inside the throat. So this is about that how we can produce sound. Now next is that how we can hear the sound. So here is the anatomy of ear or structure of the ear, which will help us to understand that how do we hear sound. So firstly there is the outer ear, after that there is a middle ear which is termed as eardrum, and after that there is the inner ear that is termed as cochlea. Firstly, the sound waves or the sound vibrations enter through the outer ear. For example, there is any source of sound and the sound waves are coming or the sound vibrations are coming from that source of sound, then these vibrations will firstly enter the outer ear. After that, these vibrations will pass through the ear canal. Ear canal is just the passage which is connecting the outer ear and the eardrum or the middle ear. Then the sound waves will pass through the ear canal to reach the eardrum. In the eardrum, there are tiny bones. The eardrum can also be termed as middle ear. So in the middle ear, there are tiny bones present which amplify these vibrations, and they will pass these vibrations to the inner ear or cochlea. Here it is written that the eardrum vibrates due to the sound, and these vibrations pass through three connected bones in the middle ear. These are the three connected bones in the middle ear, and after that the bones will amplify the vibrations, and then the vibrations are sent to the cochlea. After that, this cochlea contains a fluid, and the vibrations that are coming to the cochlea will set this fluid in motion. Then the moving fluid, this moving fluid will activate thousands of delicate hair-like cells. Delicate means soft hair-like small cells, which will convert the vibrations into the nerve impulses. Then the nerve impulses are carried or transferred to the brain through the auditory nerves, and after that the brain converts these impulses to the sound that we can hear. So in this way we can hear sound, but the way that the sound vibrations reaches have its own separate theory, because we know that sound needs a medium for its propagation. Sound always needs a medium to travel. That means there should be a medium. What is medium? Medium is that through which sound can travel, like light can pass through vacuum, but sound cannot pass through vacuum. It always needs a medium, and medium can be air, water, or any other medium like glass. So as we know that on this earth air is present, and due to the presence of the air, which is a medium for the sound waves, we can hear each other's sound, because there are certain particles present in the air which will pass the energy from one particle to the another. For example, if energy is given to the first particle, sound energy is given to the first particle, then it will transfer its energy to the second particle, then the second will transfer to the third particle, and after that this process will go on till the sound energy reaches to the particle that is near to our ear. So in this way the sound will transfer to the outer ear, and then the internal process will take place, and after that it will converted to the sound in the brain that we can hear. So this is the process that how we can hear the sound. Now we will talk about the wave, how we can say that sound is a wave. As we know that sound is produced by vibrations of the particles, and the vibrations are the result of the back and forth movement of the particles. So we can say that sound is a wave, because a wave represents the to and fro and back and forth moving of the particles in the medium, or like in air, if particles get concentrated in a medium, they will come close to each other and again they will get expand. So they will move to and fro and back and forth. So in this wave we can say that wave is also a vibration, or vibration is can be termed as a wave. For example, when we throw a pebble, like pebble means a stone, in the water, then it will create ripples in the water, ripples like this. The water will spread out over a long distance in the form of these circles that are termed as waves, that are termed as water waves. Likewise, when a sound is produced, vibrations are created which enables us to hear sound, and these vibrations are called sound waves. And these vibrations, as I have already told us, these can travel through air, water, or any solid as the sound waves. And these sound waves can travel from one source to the another in all the directions. Now, ultimately we can say that the brain is that which hears the sound, but the ears are only the aids, or these are the helping hands which will help in hearing the sound, the particular sound. Now, there is an activity. This activity is to show that sound is produced by a vibrating body. So for this we can just do a simple activity at our home. For this we need two pencils, and we can take an elastic rubber band. Here they have taken a thin metal wire. We can also take a rubber band. So when we stretch, we will stretch the rubber band at the ends with the help of pencils, and after that if we give a certain jerk, small jerk means if we push or pull this rubber band in the middle, then the vibrations or the waves will be produced at the center. So the tightly stretched wire is, or the rubber band is plugged at the center, and it will start vibrating, and the vibrating elastic rubber band will produce sound. And these vibrations will, when these vibrations will stop, then no sound will produce. The sound will hear only up to that if the vibrations will go on, otherwise no sound will be produced. So we can conclude that sound is always produced by a vibrating body. For that we have another experiment, and that is the musical instrument, or we can say that it is a laboratory equipment which is termed as tuning fork. What is tuning fork? Tuning fork is also a source of sound, and this tuning fork is used in labs to do the experiments regarding the study of vibrations and regarding the study of the sounds. So what is tuning fork? A tuning fork is a U-shaped instrument which is consisting of two arms, and that arms are termed as prongs, and the handle of this tuning fork is termed as stem or base, from which we carry this tuning fork, or from which we handle this tuning fork. So how it works, that when we hit this tuning fork with the rubber pad, then it will produce vibration. These prongs will produce vibration. These will vibrate like this, and we can find out the vibrations if we take a container which is filled with water, and we place this tuning fork inside the container, then we can feel the vibrations, because the vibrations will also produce in the water. So in this way we can do this activity also to see the vibrations, or we can see that the sound is produced by the vibrating objects. Now there are some other sources of sound like musical instruments, and there are different type of musical instruments like percussion instruments, stringed instruments, or wind instruments that we will learn in the next video. So I hope these concepts will clear to you. Thank you.